Brenda Novak. I'd like to introduce you to my husband, Ted.
Hi there.
Who I've been married to for almost 33 years. This is my daughter, Alexa.
Hello.
She has been working for me for about 7 months now, and she handles some social media things and a bunch of other stuff. Everything that young, smart people can do much better than me, I toss over to her. So anyway, super excited to have them with me because today we are celebrating the release of a new book. And I cannot believe that Finding Our Forever is 50-something. I don't even know which one. I know I'll be at 61. Let's see. Here it is. You can see the book. There's Finding Our Forever. And this one just hit bookstores today. Well, actually, it came out a little early. I spotted it in Walmart for almost a week now. So some of you may have already gotten it from there. Anyway, it's available everywhere books are sold. I've been out hunting. It never gets old to have a new book come out. Ever since I had the dream of becoming an author, it's something that keeps me rejuvenated and excited every day. And every time I have a new book come out, I'm actually out hunting to see where I can find it too, just to get a look at it in stores. So that's always fun. So anyway, what we decided to do, we have so many fun things going on that I wanted to share with you a little bit about the setting of Silver Springs. It's a fictional town, and it's a series that's going to be a lot like Whiskey Creek in that it's going to be filled with a lot of emotion and a lot of poignancy and characters who feel real, definitely not overly idolized. But it's also going to be different because Whiskey Creek was set, as you know, in a gold country town, which is Northern California, not far from where I live. A very distinctive setting. This is Southern California, and a lot of people who live in California understand that it's almost like two different states. Northern California is really different from Southern California. So Silver Springs is based on Ojai, and that's why I'm coming to you live from Ojai. It's a darling little town, and we're going to show you a little bit of it. Unfortunately, it's raining today pretty badly, so that's not too exciting. We will deal with that as we can and hope you'll get to see as much as possible, but obviously you won't get to see everything because of the rain. But before I tell you too much about Silver Springs, I want to go into just a few fun things we're doing for release day. One of those is I have an online book group, and if you haven't heard of this, you really need to look it up because it's a group of 7,000 amazing women, very avid readers, and we have so much fun together. We have a whole list of fun things that we do. It's at brendanovak.com. If you click on the book group, there's a link to be able to join, but there's also a whole list of all the other fun things that we do. I mean, we give away personalized bookmarks. We have a pin, a special designation pin for and any of my readers who have read 50 or more of my books. So those are my most avid readers. And we actually have had a lot of people turn in for their pin already. So we've been sending those out. We have an in-person launch party. I mean, just a lot of things. So you got to take a look at that. And right now, for the release of Finding Our Forever, we're doing this fun sales count. So as we reach certain sales levels, just within our little group, then we unlock a whole new tier of prizes that we're going to give away for a big party that we're having in April. It'll be April 20th at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 5 p.m. Pacific. And it's just going to be a huge fun party where I'll do another live event and we'll be giving away all these things that everybody in the book group has, you know, clicked on their little poll to win. So we've already hit the first sales level. I think we're actually pretty close to hitting the second, which will unlock 10 t-shirts that are like this. These are one of our book group t-shirts. I don't know if you can see it. It says Eat, Sleep, Read. We have one that says My Nights Are All Booked, which is also cute. We have another one that says Professional Reader, and they're available in different styles and different colors. This one I'm actually taking to Sandra Brown, and I'm sure if you're a big reader, you recognize Sandra Brown's name. I've been reading her for years. She was big before I even started writing, and she writes phenomenal books. So this month in our book group, we are reading Sting, which is her latest release. And I'm going to go, as soon as I leave Ojai, I will be getting on a plane, heading down to LA and flying out of LAX to go to Arlington, Texas, where I will be interviewing Sandra in her home on Thursday for those in our book group who will be tuning in to another live event like this one. So if you would like to be part of that, you can submit questions to her that I can ask for you and interact with her on a live event. And that's on the event page of our book group, which is a Facebook book group. But the reason why I'm sending you to my website to learn about it is because it has all those links and gives you the summary of everything that you'll need to know how we do things in book group and how to jump in and get involved, because we'd love to have you join us. So a little bit about Silver Springs now. I wanted to reveal something. I can't miss that. That's right. We have Sandra Brown this Thursday at 8 p.m. Eastern time as our event, you know, the live event I just told you about. Then I told you we're going to have a big party that we're going to do for Finding Our Forever for April. And normally I wait until much later to reveal who our guest authors are going to be. But in May, we have somebody so special that I have to announce it. And it's going to be the fabulous Robin Carr with her new release that comes out at the end of April. So super excited that I will be doing a live event and interviewing Robin Carr in Vegas at her home. So I have some really fun things coming up. So definitely don't miss the book group. Like my page at author Brenda Novak, and also look for Brenda Novak's book group in the search box on Facebook if you want to find it that way. So anyway, join us for that. It'll be fun. And now let me tell you a little bit about my new series. So as I said, it's set in a fictional town, but it's based a great deal on a town like Ojai. And what's great about it is it has this, it feels sort of secluded here because we're in the middle of a valley, and I'm hoping with the rain you'll get to see a little bit more of that, but I'm not sure. And it's based on a woman named Ayanna Tucker who has this dark secret in her past that causes her to want to compensate. And so how she's compensated for that is she has started this boys ranch. And if you're not familiar with what a boys ranch is, it's basically a reformatory school, a boarding school where you can send troubled teens, maybe people kids who are acting out and getting in trouble with the law, who need a little bit of extra time and attention. So she's taken these broken boys and under her wing. She's actually adopted 8 of them. And Finding Our Forever is about Elijah, which is her oldest of the 8, and how he finds love and comes to heal. And so I think I'm drawn to these type of stories because I love wounded heroes and I love helping people heal. So it's kind of cathartic for me to write stories about people who maybe have faced difficult struggles in the past and how they find out how to cope. They figure out how to cope and become whole and be able to give to the world. And so I think that's a beautiful thing. And that's what happens in Finding Our Forever. And with the subsequent stories, we'll also deal with other boys who have gone through the school, but not all of them will be broken. Some will be ones who are helping others. So it'll be a really great series, I hope. I hope you'll think so, because we have 4 of those brand new stories coming out this year, beginning with Finding Our Forever. So let's get started on our tour. This is the cutest little hotel. I love it, especially the outside of it and the landscaping. It's called the Blue Iguana, and it's just a few miles outside of Ojai. And as you can see, it's just a lot of green foliage, a lot of flowering plants, a lot of vines like wisteria. It also has this Spanish Revival architecture everywhere in Ojai. It's like, it's almost as if, I wonder if that's a building ordinance. I haven't checked into it, but almost everything is made, you know, designed out of the Spanish Revival architecture. So you can see just how beautiful this is, how they take their landscaping very seriously. Oh, we're going to go out into the rain now. And what we're going to actually do is we're going to get in the car and we're going to drive down to Ojai and we're going to show you what the architecture looks like. And I'm hoping too that you'll get to see some of the surrounding hills and mountains, because that's kind of what makes it feel cut off and special. And the town is so small, but they don't allow any chains in town, which is really cool. They foster small business. And so you'll see chains just outside of town or in other towns nearby, but you won't see any downtown Ojai. So you'll get to come take a peek at that. I don't want my daughter to get hurt over here. And so we're going to jump in the car real quick. There goes my mic. Okay, so, well, if you're live, then everything isn't always perfect. So there goes my mic. Let me put it on again. We will get out here and head to town. And our first stop is going to be the museum, which is a really cool building. But meanwhile, we are going to tell you a little bit about how Ted and I found our forever. And Alexa is going to help us out with that to kind of guide the conversation.
Yeah, so first of all, how did you meet Dad?
How did I meet him? Well, I am a person that, I'm an introvert. I'm a book lover. A lot of book lovers are introverts. So I don't come off that way. People are surprised to hear that, but that's true. So I typically hook up with people who are much more social than I am. I guess it's a way that I can also branch out and take advantage of their strengths. And Ted is probably the most social person I've ever met. And my roommate was also, her name was Lisa, and she was super social. And she would bring home people all the time. And she went to a party. She joined a fraternity or a sorority. Well, it wasn't really a sorority because I was going to BYU. They were clubs. They called them clubs. And she joined a club, which I didn't rush one and didn't do that. But she did, and that put her in touch with a lot of people. And her club had a dance with Ted's club. And that's how they met for the first time. And she brought him home to my apartment. And I remember as he walked in, he got this big smile on his face and said hello. And I just thought, oh my gosh, that's got to be the cutest kid I've ever seen.
All right. So,
oops, that's as far as it goes. Are we okay?
Okay. All right. So, Dad, what did you first think when you saw Mom?
Well, I gave her roommate a ride home, and I walked in the apartment and met Brenda. And I thought, oh, I met the wrong roommate again. So I became friends with the apartment. Her roommate eventually got a boyfriend, and then I asked Brenda out for our first date.
Okay, so I remember hearing something about how Dad broke up with you. What happened there?
Yes, I remember that well. I was really excited about him because he was probably the nicest boy I'd ever dated. Really nice, generous, and kind. And I thought he was so cute. And anyway, I was very excited about him. And apparently a little too excited because he thought I was too nice. I've never had that complaint before. And so he broke up with me telling me I wasn't the one about, I don't know, it was only a few weeks after we started dating. And so I remember calling my mother in tears and telling her Ted broke up with me. And she, I'll never forget what she said. She was totally calm and wasn't worried about it. She goes, oh, honey, he'll come back.
Thank you. When did you first realize that you loved Mom?
So after I broke up with her, I started dating another girl, and I realized, you know, Brenda was really so fun to be with. I really liked being with her better. And then I went out to California to work for the summer, and I called her on her birthday and said, love you. And I was ready to hang up, love you, and then hang up. But she said, why? I said, what do you mean, why? So then I had to realize why I missed her, and it was because I really wanted to be with her, and it was the first time that I had left school and gone to work in California and had really missed the girl that I was dating before, so I realized this was something special.
Nice. Right, so this is a little bit of Ojai. It's kind of hard to see, but it's really green and lush here, really beautiful.
Yeah, we're going to be at the Boys Ranch real soon. Well, it's not a Boys Ranch. We actually found a school here, and the funny thing is that I did not know that they had this type of school here. I was doing a fictional town, so I could populate it with what I wanted to. So I put my Boys Ranch in this town, and then as we came to Ojai just yesterday, we drove past this school that looked exactly like how I picture my Boys Ranch to a certain extent. I mean, they have horses and everything, so we'll show you that in a second. But I wanted to tell you really quick one thing. When he was talking and he said that, I said to him, why do you love me? I really wanted to know because, I mean, it's not how I would typically react to something, but I wanted to know because, oh, here's the school, Ojai Valley School. You can see that there's equestrian stuff everywhere. See all the horses stalls up here? They've got the ball field and the basketball field and everything, but they also have horses, which is really cool. But anyway, the reason why I asked him why is because he, you know, had broken up with me once already, because you could see from one mountain to the other and drive over to it really quickly. And you drove through a lot of orchards, orange orchards, in order to do that last night. So sadly, because of the rain, you're not able to really see. Oh, Ted, did you you got it. Okay, good. We're getting to the museum. Anyway, so this town was, its name stands for nest. At least that's the common understanding of it, that it's a Native American word that stands for nest. And this town is, it's kind of held in this little tiny valley with these surrounding hills and mountains. And so it feels, like I said, a little cut off, and yet very quaint and artsy and upscale. I really, really like it here, so. Hopefully that you guys are enjoying this too. If you can see much of it, wait till you see this cute museum. Ojai has about 7,500 people in it as far as population. I didn't go that big with my Silver Springs fictional town. I decided to keep it even just a little smaller than that. So it's only about 5,000 people. But can you see how they have this?
This is the museum. Really cute. Now we'll take you down to town.
So anyway, they have this beautiful Spanish architecture everywhere, and that's a perfect example that you probably saw out the window, and you know, the red tile roofs. So anyway, we will get back to our finding our forever as we hit our next stop, which is going to be downtown, where they have a lot of art galleries. There's a lot of art here. And so we'll show you some of those shops in just a second. I don't know if you can also see out these rainy windows, darn it.
Yeah. So when you were dating, I heard that you would knock doors for him. I can't imagine you knocking doors. How did that work out?
How did a shy girl end up knocking doors? Yeah. For a living. That was a challenge for me. I'll be honest with you. That was really hard. But I'm really glad I did it. It was a great experience. What happened was he wanted me to move out to California with him, which meant I would have to give up my job. And because we'd be coming back to school in the fall, we weren't engaged. I didn't know we wouldn't be going back to school. I was trying to figure out, you know, gosh, if I give up my job, how am I going to get a job in LA for less than 2 months? I didn't think we'd be able to do that. But he said, well, you can just come and work for me. So I came out to California, Long Beach, and I would go at night and I would knock doors, total strangers, and it was kind of scary because I was barely 20 years old and I'm showing up in this neighborhood of, you know, total strangers going door to door. But I would set appointments for him and he would go back and sell insulation. And then we actually did quite well those 2 months. Those were his best 2 months when I was doing that for him. And it enabled us to be able to go to the beach all day and just hang out and have fun with our friends. And then we'd only work a few hours at night. And we actually won the big Hawaii incentive, which provided us with a trip to Hawaii shortly after we were married. So it turned out to be a lot of fun, and it has trained me a lot on how to overcome my fear and self-consciousness at getting in front of other people. So I'm actually glad that I did that. Not that I think I'd want to volunteer for doing that again, but definitely glad he taught me how to do that and to overcome that fear.
Dad, when did you decide to get married?
Well, we were sitting around talking, and I looked at Brenda, and I said, we're going to get married, aren't we? And she goes, you're just now figuring that out? So she already had known what was going to happen in the future, I guess. But it just, from that point, just progressed toward marriage.
And then, where did you get married, Mom?
We got married in Utah. We did return to Utah, where I had a scholarship at BYU, so I thought for sure I'd go back to school. So we returned to Utah to get married, but he was not actually going to school when I met him there. He was carrying a backpack and pretending like he was going to school, but he was actually only looking for a wife. So once he found me, he was done. He wanted to you know, head out and make his millions or whatever he had planned to do. So he talked me into not going back to school and to entering the workforce, and he wanted to move back to California. And we spent just a few months in the Bay Area, and then we had a job opportunity open up in sales, of course, in Sacramento. And so we moved up to Sacramento. And it's kind of interesting, where you land when you're a young couple is often where you put down roots and stay, because once you have children and they have friends and you make friends and you get them in school, it's really kind of hard to uproot them. At least it was for us. So we've been in Sacramento almost the entire 32 years of our marriage, and I don't know that I'll ever leave it. I really love it there.
Thanks. Why do you think your relationship has lasted so long? 33 years, right?
You know, I've had a few people ask me that because it is unusual to have your marriage last that long. And I tell them, well, we have this agreement. I make the big decisions and Brenda makes the small decisions. And they say, really? Well, how do you know when it's a big decision and when it's a small decision? I say, well, we haven't had any big decisions yet, but when we do, I'm sure she'll let me know.
Yeah, honey, none of them have been big. You're okay still. I've got it.
So why do you think, Mom?
My answer is probably a little more serious. I really feel like he's taught me a lot about emotional trust. I grew up without a ton of emotional trust. And I remember when we had our first argument, how I kind of went for it more than he did. And because that's kind of how I was raised, you know, with a lot of more contention and fighting. And so I remember him looking at me like, oh my goodness, like you don't have to go that far. And I've realized ever since then that I don't have to go that far, that I can trust him emotionally. And he just calms me down and makes me feel warm and happy. And so it's worked out well. I hope I have him forever.
I told Brenda, I said, Brenda, if you didn't end up being a writer, you could have been a great attorney. Because after an argument, I would think for a half hour, oh, I should have said this, I should have said that. But Brenda never has those. She's like right on her game, man. So I learned early on it wasn't a good idea to argue. It was just better to get along and have fun.
And now that you think he must be totally passive, that isn't right either. My kids will tell you that he is not a passive individual either. But anyway, we're opposites, and I think opposites do attract, and I think that works for us. So
now we are entering downtown Ojai, so we'll show you a bit about that. It's really cool architecture. And there's a lot of cute shops down here on the left under these archways.
There's also a beautiful park that's coming up on your right. We'll show you a little more of that when we're on the opposite side of the street, maybe. But here's a good spot. You can see that it's right. Very little town. It's just this kind of like town center, and it has this really cute Spanish Revival pillars and stuff. And then on the left is where you have kind of just a long string of these little boutiques of different clothing boutiques, or there's an ice cream store, and there's wine tasting, a little restaurant, and so just all these cute places. So even the gas station here is kind of cute. We're going to try and get a parking space just down here, and we'll walk you down here in a second. Very good. Oh, you cut somebody off the way. Do you want to show the shops? Let's yeah. Can you turn and show? I don't know which one's working now. There we go. Okay, anyway, this will give you a better view because we're out of the misty windows. And I'm so sad you can't see the mountains. There's mountains all over. Mountains all on the other side. And it's really a special place. So we drove down here hoping to show it to you. And then, wouldn't you believe, it rains today. And it didn't even rain yesterday. But oh well, at least I hope you can see how cute and beautiful and quaint and well taken care of this place is. The people who live here love it and take great care of it. So it's a place I love to come and visit. So I hope that you will feel the same, that Silver Springs will be a place that you'll want to come visit again and again, especially because I have 4 books coming out this year in this series. We have No One But You, which will be out in June, Until You Loved Me, which will be out in August, and then Right Where We Belong, which is what I'm just finishing up now, that'll be out in November. So I hope you'll run out and get a copy of Finding Our Forever today and celebrate my new release with me. Thanks so much for joining me. Oh, don't forget to comment today. If you comment on this thread, then my publisher is going to be giving away 2 gift packs of Silver Spring stuff, and we're going to be giving away 15 bookmarks that are not only personalized with your name, but they have my signature. So we'll be picking 15 people who have commented and get those out to you. All right, have a great day. Bye. We're going to go have some ice cream. Ted deserves a reward now for being part of this.